Hello and welcome to lesson 4 of the Articy Draft Importer for Unity tutorial series. In the previous lesson, we refactored some code in the player controller script, improving the functionality of the onTriggerEnter method. And secondly, we can now display the speaker name in our dialogue UI. In this lesson, we will add functionality to the buttons of our dialogue UI, so that we can finally traverse through the entire linear test dialogue. If you are following this tutorial series via YouTube, you can find all code snippets discussed in this lesson's blog post. The link is in the video description. We are able to start a dialog we imported from Articy in our little Unity game project and display the first line of dialog and its speaker name. But as we can see in Articy, the dialog consists of more than one line, of course. So let's make the rest of the text visible in Unity as well. First, we take a quick look at how the Dialogue widget is set up. We have an image object called DialogBox on which we display the dialogue text. The speaker is a separate text object and is positioned so that the speaker name is displayed above the dialogue text. Below that, we have two buttons, one button for the dialogue choices and one button to end the dialogue. They are childed to the dialogue branches game object, which has a horizontal layout group component to position the buttons next to one another using the total width of the dialogue box. Okay, let's give these buttons some functionality. In the dialogue manager script, we add a variable of type button, which we call dialogue button, and open it to the editor via the serialized field attribute. Then we switch to Unity to drag the dialogue branch object to fill the reference we just created. Back in the dialogue manager script, we now add a listener to a button click within the start method. DialogueButton.onClick.addListener. And we are going to call ContinueDialogueOnAClick. I generate the method and remove the throw command. What are we going to do? We started our dialogue with the flow player. The flow player arrived at the first dialogue fragment, paused, and provided us with all the data we requested to show dialogue text and speaker name. But it is still pausing, so we need to tell it to get going again. This we do with flowplayer.play. Let's see what happens if we test the scene. It works. Finally, we can click through the dialogue and behold it in all its glory. Tad too much? Probably. But joking aside, we took another good step to achieve our goal to display branching dialogue imported from Articy. You will notice that at the end of the dialogue, we cannot close the window to actually conclude the dialogue. This is what we will take care of next. In the dialogue manager script, we add another variable of type button with the name endDialogueButton. Then we fill this reference field with the dialogue branch close object in Unity. To implement a button to close the dialogue, we first need to check when the dialogue ends. This we will do in the onBranchesUpdated method. Here we get passed a list of all branches following the current node. This information we can use in a for each loop to see if there is still text coming or not. In onBranchesUpdated, we declare a bool dialogue is finished and initialize it to true. Next, we start the for each loop, checking each var branch in A branches. Because of the way we set up our dialogues in Articy, with dialogue fragments nested inside of dialogue nodes, we know that the dialogue is over when no dialogue fragment can be found as the following branch target. Therefore, we make a check if any branch leads to an iDialogue fragment target. If this is the case, the current dialogue is apparently not over yet, and we set dialogue is finished to false. Okay, so as long as we have a dialogue fragment following the current node, the dialogue continues. But what is supposed to happen when it finally comes to an end? we want to deactivate the continue button and activate the end button in its stead. Then we need to add a listener to the button click to call the close dialog box method to properly conclude the current dialog, which we do in start, where we already have the listener for the other button. Let's go over to Unity and run a test. The functionality is there as intended. When we get to the end of the dialog, a working close button appears. And it even starts to bring out the layout principle I planned for the button appearance. If there is only one choice, only the button in question should be displayed, like with the close button now. The dialog is concluded, so there is no reason to keep showing the continue button. We need to make a few more adjustments to remove some issues we still have. For one, while within the dialog, we don't want to display the close button. And currently, once we concluded the dialog and addressed the NPC a second time, the close button is still there, preventing us from going through the dialog again. Go back to the Dialog Manager script. Here we start by adding one line to the Close Dialog Box method. When we hide the dialog UI, we also want to set the Close button back to an inactive state. There is one more thing we can do while we are at this location in the code. At the moment, we show the last object with text and are about to close the dialog. But on this last object, there might be an output pin containing scripts which we want to process as well. This we can do by telling the flow player to finish the current paused object. One little thing left we need to do, and that is to set the dialog button active again. We hide it in our check in on branches updated, and so far we have no way to get it back. By setting the dialog button game object to active in the start dialog method, we can easily fix this issue. Back in Unity, we set both dialog branch and dialog branch close objects to inactive, so we can control via the code when which button appears. Then we can run another test. Beautiful. We made good progress in this lesson. We added functionality to our UI buttons so that we can now traverse through the entire linear test dialog and close the dialog UI at the end. If all you want is to display linear dialog, you can basically orient yourself at the current project structure and are good to go. If you want to offer choices to your player, don't worry, we are going to start tackling that in the next lesson. We will start setting up branching functionality by instantiating buttons for the number of branches the player encounters at any part of the dialog. See you there!